So hello class. So this video is our class proper for our first topic for this term, which is introduction to accounting. But before that, let's enumerate your learning objectives for this class. First is in this topic, you will narrate the history of or narrate the history and origin of accounting. So dari ta mabalaan kung diin nag-originate kag ang history of accounting. Second, define the meaning of accounting. So what does accounting mean? Third, describe the nature of accounting. Ano iyang nature? Then explain the functions of accounting in business and identify activities and events where accounting is used in making business decisions. So I have here a presentation, share ko sa inyo. So, introduction to accounting. So first, what is the history of accounting? So, it was way back, long time ago. So, it started when the human beings lived in caves, in trees, and in other safe dwellings, wherein their main occupation was to collect root crops, vegetables, and fruits, and to prey birds and animals for their living. So, amo na ang way of living sa mga tao sa una. So, nag-start sila sa mga koyba, sa mga kahoy, and their occupation, amo na, mananom sila root crops, and hunting. Hanggang pang hunting sila. So, nanuraw ka muna yung manok. Then, they did, so to keep track of their inventory, so para ma-monitor nila ang ilang mga harvest, ang ilang ginahimo is, they draw lines and figures on stones, on walls and ceilings inside the caves, on the bark of the trees, on skins of animals, or making knots out of vines or creeping grasses. So, gina-record na nila ilang inventories kay para ma-monitor nila sa mga dingding sang koyba, so ginasulat-sulatan na nila, ginalinyahan nila. So as time passed by, man had to leave the caves and started living in groups or in tribes. So as time goes on, so kinanglan nila maghalin from one place to another place kay tribo-tribo na sila. So they need to improve their record keeping sang una. Then, they kept records of their harvest, poultry and animals by making markings and writings on the walls of their abodes, on cut woods, or making knots out of the ropes or vines. So, muna. So, improve nila ang ilang way of living. Then, societies gradually expanded and the demand of men for their necessities in terms of food and basic needs started to increase. So, there became new systems as man started to do the barter system. So, subong, nag-auso man ang barter. So, sa una pa na siya nag-originate ang barter system, which is nag-exchange sila ng goods to one another. Except money, kasi wala pa na di siya money sa una. Then, goods and it cannot be provided by their own produce. In ancient Europe, man kept records by marking accounts on the back of the doors, by drawing marks on the mud walls, writings on the skins of animals, or by marking on the sticks from wood branches or on chopped wood. So, kung ano na daw ang pwede mamarkahan, sila gamarka sa ilang inventory system or mga records ng ilang mga harvest. So later in time, a new system was introduced as the medium of exchange in doing transactions. The use of money made from minerals. So diri na nagsugod nga nagagamit na kita sang kwarta. So in these monetary activities, merchants and other types of businesses emerged and trading between persons, family, and institutions became widespread using cash or credit. So, kabalo na ang tao magamit sang cash that time. So, maintaining records was necessary for all transactions. So, with this, tungod ang tao, nagagamit ito sang kwarta, nag-increase ng transactions among people. So, So diri na nag-emerge ang need nga i-improve na ang way of recording of transactions. So then on the 15th century, modern accounting was born due to sudden increase of trade and commerce, is what I have said a while ago. The necessity of formulating specific policies and guidelines in maintaining accounts, books, and records was desired. So here in 1494, an Italian priest and philosopher wrote a book in which included in it the basic principles of double entry system of bookkeeping. So when we speak of bookkeeping, it is an activity of recording transactions. So dira. So meaning si Italian priest and philosopher in 1494, naghimo siya book in which ara dira ang basic principles of double entry system of bookkeeping or recording. So what does double entry means? So double entry means a value that is received should equal to the value that is parted with. So sa double entry system, when you record transactions, so i-record mo ang value sang na-receive mo, tag i-record mo man ang value sang gin-give up mo, which must be equal. So that is a double entry system. So who is this Italian priest and philosopher who wrote this book of accounting? So he is Luca di Pacioli, who was considered as the father of accounting. So, tungod kay Luca di Pacioli, accounting was born. So, since then, accounting being an art and a science, different methods of keeping accounts were practiced by different countries, industries. So, following the double entry invented by Luca di Pacioli, with the progress of trade and commerce and help of technology, accounting has evolved to what it is about on the present day. So, una, simple pa na siya ang system of accounting. Kay di, record mo lang ang imo na ang amount sa imo na receive kag ang amount sa imo gin give up. So, mabalance na sila nga duwa. So, mo na siya kasimple sa accounting sa hunan. Now, accounting has evolved. So, nag-complicated na siya because man nga ang transactions ng tao all around the world is become more complicated. So, that is the history of accounting. Next, so what is accounting? So, accounting is the art of recording, classifying, and summarizing in a significant manner in terms of money, transactions and events which are in part at least of financial character and interpreting the results thereof. So let's discuss the meaning of accounting one by one. First, accounting is an art. So why accounting is considered an art? So it is a part of our knowledge that helps us attain our objectives, design processes and policies, design appropriate forms and improve control. So in accounting, we design. So when we speak of design, iba sa art, yeah, kung sa art yung subject, so everyone is an artist. So in accounting naman niya, accounting is an art, kasi we have the knowledge that helps us attain our objectives. So to attain that objectives, we must design processes and policies and design appropriate forms and how to improve control. So dira na dagasulod ang art. So how do we attain our objectives? So na-create kita sang ways how to attain that. So ma-apply kita sang aton nga pagka-artist. So to get the best financial results, business transactions are recorded, classified and summarized in the best way. So if we want to get the best financial results, so when it comes to recording, classifying, summarizing business transactions, we will also do it in our best way. So everyone is an artist. So next, recording. So recording of transactions in various ways according to the accounting standards and as required according to the size of organization. So accounting is an art of recording. So gina-record naton ang mga financial transactions nga nagakatabo sa business, and it is recorded according to the accounting standards. So in accounting, as accountants, we have standards that we are following in recording transactions. So sa lain naman sa yung subject nga ginapadalman, and na-record man ang transactions according to the size of the organization. So ang recording sang small business is different sa recording sang transaction sa large scale ng mga companies. Kasi kung small ya, simple lang na yung recording. So when it comes naman niya sa mga dagkong companies, so ang ilang, more or less ang ilang recording is more complex. Third, so the art of classifying. So grouping of transactions or entry of the same nature at one account. So when we classify, so diba, we record transactions of the business. So once we record, ma-record na natin ang tanan, so we group the transactions or entries of the same nature at one account. So now classifying is, classifying process in accounting is just like you are sorting. Ginasort mo na sila ni, isa ni sila ka grupo, kay they are of the same nature, they are of the same transaction, they are in the same entries. So next, are naman nga mga transactions, we group this into we classify this into another, pasulutan ni sila into another account kay they are in the same transaction, they are in the same nature. So from that, ng we have there the art of classifying. So we classify transactions according to their nature. So next is the art of summarizing. So we record, we classify. So after classifying, we summarize. So summarize business transactions because an organization has to prepare the financial statements. So after we classify, so nagrupo na to sila, na sort na. So we have there the, now we will discuss this further, ha, ng the assets, the liabilities, so na, the equity account. So this assets, liabilities and equity, we will discuss this further for our next chapter. So maintindihan niyo na siya if matakal ta na na topic. So anyway, to summarize, balik ka sa summarizing. So, after you classify the transactions, summarize ta na siya in preparation for the financial statements na ma-prepare ta na sa para hapos na lang. So, next. So, in terms of money. So, amo to ginaisa-isa ta ang, ano, ang definitions ang accounting. So money is the measure and basis in recording transactions. So in accounting, we measure the transactions in terms of money. So kung mag-account kita, hindi ka kahambal nga, example, cash. Tada, many. So hindi man pwede. So receivables, less. So hindi na siya pwede. That is not accounting. So we must measure it in terms of money. So when speak of accounting, in terms of money, ang measurements ang transaction. So tang cash, dapat may amount git 100,000 pesos. Receivables, 50,000 pesos. So amo na sa. So that amount is based sa aton man nga na-record nga mga transaction. So in terms of money. Next. Transactions and events which impart at least of financial character. So accounting deals with financial transactions and events which are in terms of money. So in accounting, nagadeal ta dira sang financial transactions and events nga nagarelate sa aton nga business. And these financial transactions and events are measured in terms of money. So, how about non-financial? So, hindi tama na ma-quantify in terms of money ang mga non-financial transactions ang aton nga business. Like, non-financial, nag-hire ka employee. So, i-record mo na sa county. Hindi tana siya ma-measure in terms of money. Pero, when we speak of sweldo ni employee, so, pwede tana yan ma-quantify in terms of money. So, paghatag ka sweldo, so that is a financial transaction, pila ang sweldo ni employee, utang ka is 10,000, so we consider it as, so record this as expense, we record this as expense for the business. So muna siya ang transactions and events which import at least of financial character. So the almost matapos na ng definitions ang accounting. Next is interpreting the results. So, the financial results are interpreted in such a way that the results can be understood and appreciated by at least non-accounting users. So, from the recording, classifying, summarizing, then we measure the transactions in terms of money and financial character. Then after that, we interpret the results. So in interpreting the results, it must be understood and appreciated by at least non-accounting users. So it must be understandable when it comes to interpreting the results of your business transaction. So dapat naintindihan na siya. Hambal na siya bigyan ng example ang imo nga cash. So naka-record ka na summarize mo na measure mo na in terms of money. So muna pag present mo kay non-accountant, yung sino man da nga tawo nga nagakinanglan sang information about cash, so maintindihan niya dayon. And interpret the accounting information for their own purpose. So, kung ano yung purpose, when, kung i-interpret niya ina nga information, yung financial information, makuha niya kung ano ang gusto niya mabalaan. Once malantaw yan na or ma-interpret niya na nga information which is na-produce sa accounting. So, next, accounting as the language of business. So, mamove kita din. Okay. So, why is accounting considered as the language of business? So, business enterprises can only communicate themselves to users and decision makers through accounting. So, accounting serves as the language of business. Why? Sa accounting, we record the transactions. We classify these transactions, we summarize these transactions, and measure these transactions in terms of money. Then we communicate the results of it. So, si accounting, siya ni ang the term is naga-summarize and naga-measure sang financial transactions ni business. So, once makaproduce na sa isang financial information, this information will be communicated to themselves and to the users and decision makers. So, that is why accounting is known as the language of business. So, siya ang nag-communicate sa business and to the users of information nga, which is the result of the business transactions of that particular business. So, siya ni ang nag-connect sa users tag sa business. So, understood na? So, next, the nature of accounting. So, tapos na to sa definition of accounting. So, next, we'll proceed to the nature of accounting. So, anyway, kasi may na, ano ko, may na miss out. Okay, nature of accounting. So, Accounting, it is a service activity to account for economic activities and events that has value. So it is expressed in monetary terms. So muna ang nature ni accounting. Accounting is a service activity. So when we render accounting service, so muna nga term, accounting service, nahatag ko sa inyo accounting service. So i-account ko inyo economic activities and events na measurable in money, then communicate the results thereof. So accounting, so for that, so nature ya is accounting started as a science. So how did accounting started as a science? So in the history of men, where mankind had relied on their special skills and natural born intelligence, accounting was simply invented by them in a way that they could understand it. So sa una, so since wala pa ni ang technology, ang mga high-end nga mga intelligence ang tao, so mankind had relied on their special skills and natural born intelligence ang sa una. Pero kinanglanan nila i-record ang ilang or i-track ang ilang mga inventories and harvest sa una. So accounting was simply invented by them. So because of the intelligence, so kinanglanan ni record ang aton nga i-track ang aton nga inventory. So muni nag-invent sila sang way of accounting there. Activities. So they simply invented by them in a way that they could understand it. So invent nila in a way nga maintindihan man lang nila ang ilang obra. So muna, accounting started as a science. So it was defined as an art. So matukaginas what I have mentioned earlier sa definitions ng accounting. Accounting is an art. So the art is on the recording aspect, classifying, summarizing, and interpreting. So, di ba? We need, amo to kagi na to review, we need to achieve our goals. So, to achieve our goals, we design our recording process, classifying process, and summarizing process. So, when art is applied, processes and policies are made uniquely uniquely for the business, including management reports which are customized as needed by the users. So it was defined as an art, accounting. Next, it became a discipline. So accountancy profession in the practice of it is governed by sets of rules and accounting standards. So that is why accounting has become a discipline. Okay? It is already governed by sets of rules and accounting standards. And also, accountants are bound by the code of ethics. So, kasunod, every profession man siguro nagasunod gid sa code of ethics. So, we must be ethical in all our ways. Third, next, accounting has become an information system. So, whether manual or computerized, accounting is a whole information system. So, since si accounting siyang nag-summarize sa mga business transactions, sa mga businesses, and this through this, it produced an information which is very useful to the users, to the intended users, and for the decision maker. So that is why it became an information system, whether it is manual or computerized. So it generates information that is useful in the decision making process, as what I have said. So next, what are the functions of accounting? First, identifying and analyzing source documents which enter into the information system. So, ano ang function ni accounting? So, ang function niya is to identify and analyze source documents which enter into the information system. So, in conducting a business, every transaction is supported by a source document. Paresina, si business, nagbakal sa importante buy and sell. Buy and sell na business. Nag-buy and sell siya groceries. So, it's a merchandising business. So, si owner ni business, nagbakal merchandise. It is a business transaction, a business merchandising business. It is a financial transaction. Magbakal siya, tagaan siya resibo ni supplier. That receipt will be considered as a source document. So, di ba may source document? So, si accounting, masulun dira ang function ni accounting, which is to identify and analyze that source document kung diin siya masulod ni information system. So, di ba nagbakal? Nagbakal na to si owner sang business kay supplier. Naghatag si supplier source document. Gin-identify, gin-analyze, gin-record sa information system. So, function of accounting. So, these are activities that are relevant to the business operation. So, we only record activities that is relevant only to the business operations. Kung nagkaon si owner sa Jollibee, hindi na yung transaction ni business. So, we don't need to record that. Accounting only tackles or si accounting gasudod lang na sa iya nga function if the transaction is related or relevant only to the business operations. So, transactions are called inputs which are processed into the information system and are generated as financial and management reports. So, si transactions, these are considered as inputs. So, sila ni ang nagasulod sa information system. And after that, makasulod na, na-record na, na-classify na, in-account na. From there, pwede ka na ka-generate sa mga financial and management reports. Next function is recording the source documents. Recording the source documents, which are economic activities into the books of accounts of the organization. So, functions are one of the functions ni accounting is the recording of source documents, which are economic activities into the books of accounts. So later, later in this term, we will discuss about the books of accounts na ginagamit sa accounting. So, what is this called? The function of recording. So, the function of recording is called bookkeeping. So, si bookkeeping nag-focus lang din na sa recording of financial transactions of the business. In the accounting information system, it is called transaction processing. So, bookkeeping or transaction processing, they are the same. Next, preparing the financial and management report. So, after your record, sulod si accounting. Again, ang definition ni accounting, you identify, classify, summarize, measure in terms of money. And after that, if na-record na tanan, na-account na tanan, you can now prepare the financial and management report. So what are these financial reports which are considered as the products of accounting? First is the statement of financial position, which is also known as the balance sheet. Dira naton makita ang assets, liabilities, and equity accounts, which amuna siya ang accounting equation naton nga i-tackle later sa aton nga term. Second is the statement of income or the income statement. Third is the statement of cash flows and statement of changes in equity. So, So that is financial reports. However, may ara meta management reports are those that are essential in the review of the business financial performance and operation. So most likely ang management report amo ni siya ang management reports amo ni siya ang mga reports nga kinahanglan sa management when it comes to reviewing the financial performance and operations of the company, which is essential in their decision-making process. So examples of these management reports are like sales reports, HR reports, so hindi na siya yung financial report ha. Aging of accounts receivable, payables, mga in-house nga mga reports na kinanglan sa management. So next, last is analyzing and interpreting the financial reports for different users who have interest in the business and who will use this in their decision making. So when it comes to interpreting the financial information or the financial reports for the different users, we have a separate topic for this. So muna siya, functions of accounting. So that is the end of chapter 1. So before that, ma-add ko danay some of the accounting results that are helpful in making business decisions. Amo to kagina ginamba ko sa management reports, which are management reports which are considered as management reports which are considered as the products man of accounting. So the use of aging report or accounts receivable, aging reports of accounts payable, so use of trend reports and analysis of sales performance. So dira naman niya ga-focus ang report niya na nag it shows kung nag-increase or nag-decrease ang sales sa isa ka business. Then the use of expense reports and analysis, dira gina isa-isa ang mga expenses and gina-analyze if this expense nag-increase bala sa sini nga tuig or wala, and so on. And the use of accounting and monitoring inventories. So that's it. That's all about chapter 1, which is introduction to accounting. So hopefully you understand the topic from the history of accounting, definition of accounting, nature of accounting, functions of accounting, the products or the financial reports that are produced from accounting. So thank you very much. If you have any questions, feel free to message in our group chat, and have a nice day ahead. Thank you.